We don't hurt little girls in Dorne.
Everywhere in the world they hurt little girls.
Good day, Jamaica. Torina Beckford here. So recently we see a spike in the violence committed against women, and we are here concerned, wondering, you know, what can be done to protect the nation's women? Because especially Canice Jackson case that has been highly publicized, we see a teacher being recently abducted or disappeared. We don't know the true nature of her disappearance as yet. So definitely we see this increased aggression against our nation's women, and we're concerned about that. We wonder how we can protect the women. So I have 10 ideas, 10 ways women can better protect themselves in Jamaica. And I'm going to outline these ways, and hopefully the government and other groups can step forward and assist women in empowering themselves and protecting themselves, so that we can see a decrease in the violence or a complete elimination of violence against women. So the first one is, women should acquire stun guns and pepper spray and have them at all time. These instruments of personal protection can give a woman a fighting chance when confronted by not only criminals, but jealous boyfriends and anybody who are seeking to harm her. So we definitely need the government to and business owners to start importing a lot of stun guns and pepper sprays. And the ban on stun gun needs to be removed. Gunmen have too much gun in this country. As if everybody a beat AK and them thing, they feed the government a tell we say law abiding citizens can't have access to stun gun. But when election time come, them a smuggle gun that they get to dance them and the criminals them. No! This government and the other party don't have the authority to tell we so we can have stun gun to protect ourselves. They have been unable to stop the gun flow in Jamaica because we do not make guns. We don't have gun factory in Jamaica. And we still have the heap of guns that are flowing out of the country. So we know I hear the government I tell about what dangerous and what not dangerous. The gunman them wanna back, wanna support dangerous. So we need the woman them to have stun gun, to have effective means of protecting themselves, because pepper spray simply is not enough. So we want to see that. And we want the government to have police that disarm the woman them. Because we love have Jamaican people as sitting ducks, while the whole like criminal element them in the country have advanced weapons bigger than police gun. Criminal have gun bigger than police gun, but common citizens where the criminal them take a toll against. Nothing have nothing to protect yourself. So we are watch government. The second idea is to acquire self-defense training. Martial arts, taekwondo, taijitsu, any one of them means by which you protect yourself, and keep it a secret. Because guess what? Unsuspecting attackers can easily be disarmed, but they have to be unsuspecting. And one of the things we realize is that the people who are attacking the women are people who are connected to them, are them boyfriend, them ex-boyfriend, them jealous husband. And these are the people who are killing off the woman them mostly. And a bad man and gunman really do it. That we realize. So we are saying, no, you come, you get some self-defense training. You don't have to make your boyfriend know. You got self-defense training class. You have to go make up some form of excuse here out to the girls or something. Some way. And somehow you have some jealous boyfriend who are watching 24/7. It will be difficult. But you can't make him know that, because him you protect against. You can't make him know, because when he unsuspect him, he's easier for this time when he come against you. Rather than I know and say, yeah, martial arts ching, so he go pick up all one board out and do and start swing. You see me, I say? So you have to know and be smart, ladies. You can't make no man take you as no fool. You see me, I say? And so the third idea is that me want to see the police force introduce an app where a woman can just go in her phone and press my location, and he goes straight to the police station where she is located currently. And that means that she currently in a danger, and she want the police know her current location. So when she in a taxi, when she there anyway, and she feels threatened, a woman can have a convenience of alerting the police so the police know where she is. Although the police might take a little time to reach, at least, she can have that benefit there of alerting the police, and the police depend on them way. Hopefully by the time them reach them can save her. And we want a taxi database app. This is the fourth idea. We want a taxi database app for exist now. What we want now is to see a database where all of the taxi man them name in the them license plate and so on, and a picture of them face. That I basic info. More information can be there, but that I info what we need for work. So a taxi stop at woman foot now, a red plate. She now stop and look at the taxi license plate, put it in the app, and him name and him face will pop up. She looking at the taxi, she not see that the man the way ready taxi register. Now. It could have been a gunman with thief the taxi for kidnap people. So we have to have that database to make sure the legitimate taxi operators them operating. It taxi them. And not only that, if she go in the taxi after she sees the license plate match the face, She can't register on the app that she in a this taxi. So she go missing. We know which taxi have her. We know which taxi she last traveling. So we just go find that the man there and find out what happened to the girl. And maybe sometime we find out the serial killer them were in the taxi service, were in the taxi industry, in the transportation industry, a camouflage themselves. Many times them I run a legitimate taxi for years for people trust them. And every now and then when one little girl come in at the NKR at night time, vulnerable, their instincts turn on back, them are animal, them are serial killer, and the little girl they just disappear. And I know, see, I see them taxi boy, we're out there every single day. I operate as taxi driver, legitimately, everybody know him. And I say, me know this a taxi man here. Yeah. Him a the damn serial killer. So we are say, we want the taxi database system. Because we not trust none of them taxi board. We feel say, a kidnapping ring operating at the transportation industry right now. And we want the government to start set up sting operations throughout the whole country. Because we want to catch the taxi man them. We are thief for the woman them. And them did enough. And we know that. The fifth idea now is, we want the government to set up domestic abuse safe houses throughout the country. So in every parish, a woman will get beat by her husband, she has no money, she has no if you stay. She can just retreat, just grab a couple things, go through the gate, and she there want domestic abuse safe house. You see me I say? Because many times that make a woman them dead, they might get abused for a long time. And the abuse consistently increase. And them want to leave, but them not have nowhere to go. And then they turn this until man kill them off. You see me I say? So we need the domestic abuse health safe house there. And we want police there nearby or some form of guard system. Because enough time when the woman them go missing, the man them will end up over there. So man will pressure that place there. Jealous man them will go kick off door over the safe house. And we can't have that. So we have to have force over there. We have to have security. We want some walls built around the safe house. So you know, convenient for no man, no abusive man come in and try to target them woman. Because jealous man will do that. So we have to understand if we're serious about protecting the woman them, we have to start thinking of every way possible of how they can be armed. Even when we implement safety measures, we have to think how others can jeopardize them safety measures there. So we want to make sure them safe houses are well protected. Now hopefully all the little police base can operate near to it and be multitasking. Protect the safe house and protect the area at the same time. You know them way there? We just incorporate a couple things in our initiative. So yes, the sixth idea is we are going to go back to school. Now. We are going to focus on the school system and the problem with family and socialization. Now, Jamaica now, we see say, yo, many of them youth get socialized for things a woman subordinate. You're supposed to beat a woman. You're supposed to control a woman. Many of them girls that grow up for things say, you're supposed to look up for a certain type of man way, deal with a certain way. Maybe this traditional speech say, if a man not beat him, not love you. All them things need to be eliminated. So we want to grow the youth them in a way where them understand their rights and it's a genuine legitimate relationship with them if you have to a woman. So we're going to teach the woman them in a primary and high school about women's rights, the rights of women supposed to have. We're going to teach them their history. We're going to make them understand when women get the rights to vote, all of them things there. And make them understand say wrong is that there's a history of exploitation for women, when men exploit women and hold them back for whatever means. And they need to understand that. Understand themselves as women, because in order for we have strong women to produce a stronger future generation, we have to empower and love women them and respect them to the point that we want them to have the best. So at that I think, if we not teach women's their rights, then I'm going to understand how a man's supposed to treat them. Because many of them don't have a father figure in their life. We grow them right way, we grow them soft and loving and protective. They don't have that. Their fathers will beat them. Many of them out there, them fathers have sex with them right now. And a true thing, so them don't know how a man's supposed to treat them. So we need to teach a woman them how they're supposed to be treated, and we need to teach a man to respect women's rights. So at the same time, I will spit the girl them and the boy them, and the girl them, I teach them women's rights, we I teach the man them how to respect women's rights, and teach them what's wrong and what's right. Yeah, you know, for this and for that, you know, boy, a box down girl in her face, and you're this and that, and you know, who and her, she's a human being. You see me I say? So them they think they need to be related because enough man not really understand them thing, I know. So enough time when the woman them want to left them and the woman them want their freedom to go to a ladies' night and enough of them things, the man them not understand see, a people them are deal with, adult. Them just take you say, I'm a woman, you're supposed to be on my foot, cause that me say daddy do with mommy. And if mommy says she want to go, daddy beat her. We need to eliminate that. So at that we want to see the education system reflect the reality there. And so our next thing we want to do is encourage women them to report suspicious behavior and threats against their life. This is number 7. Me now recently hear a brother named Peter on a voice note come out and I threaten this woman crazily. I mean, me utterly convinced that Peter go cut this woman's throat. And this woman actually says she not gonna report it. So that is the next thing too. We have to give you a chance to intervene in an abusive situation by reporting this abusive situation. Friends and family also, enough time with you somewhere, even stranger, you hear your neighbor get beaten, you don't know them. You call the police because it's a issue of concern. So if you stop act like say domestic violence are people business. I know people business. The amount of women them we are dead because of domestic violence. I know people business again. So stop talking about who are full for business and what. You need to get in a people business when they over there beat their woman. And enough time we hear women get beaten and we conveniently and casually take it say I feel them business when I intervene. We stop it. If you come to the protection of people, I get harmed. Whether man I get beaten, woman I get beaten, or even pick me I get beaten. We need to start stand up for people who get abused and stop going like say a people business. You don't have no business if you're a criminal. If you abuse somebody, you don't have no business. Everybody in the community if you can turn down power, you are new so in your business. You don't have any personal life once you commit one crime. So we need to start understand. Say once a woman cry out and you suspect domestic abuse, as immediately your business. Are you obligated to say something? If you don't say something, you're not real youth. You're done real. So we have put that out there to everybody. And even although this should have been the second one, this is the eighth one still. This the eighth point. Where we say, once the woman them acquire firearms. Yeah, man. Once the woman them acquire firearm and firearm training. Because sometimes this stun gun and pepper spray don't make a difference. You see me, I say, and not only that. It's all in the public now, say woman arm themselves. Some man prepare for that already. You see me, I say, so sometimes a woman need adequate force to protect themselves. A gunman, them out there have gun. Every gunman have gun. And if you want to turn gunman tomorrow, you can't get a gun. So why the woman them for protect themselves, them can't get a gun? And that we want to know, once the government play a role in training these women and part pay for them gun. Because enough of our citizens cannot afford a weapon. And that because they're poor and can't afford a weapon means say you nothing have access to a means by which to protect yourself. Because a gun is a means to protect yourself in Jamaica. A gun the enemy have. A gun the destructive elements them in the country have. So they're nice. See, the woman them have a little nice little handgun in them purse where them take training, you know, arrange if you know how to use it. And them have them nice little concealed carry weapon where them can protect themselves against boyfriend, jealous this, jealous that. And them think they're rapists, man, we are kidnap woman, human trafficker. Woman have too much people that go after them right now for them not really have access to a gun. Appear rich man we see with gun and them thing. They want about the woman them. Who wants to see woman them have more gun? And enough women in Jamaica have gun and that need to change. All of the teachers, them are the civil servant. Every civil servant, female. If you want to have a gun, government will play a part in making sure you're armed. That's the reality of the situation. Because them not stem crime, them can't stem the gun flow, and them can't disarm the criminal population. So them can't tell you nothing about stun gun, and them can't tell you nothing about we desire to have a weapon. Because them can't save we, them can't protect we. Law enforcement can't do enough to save all our life. Them can't even reach on the scene on time because naturally them not have enough resources. So the next thing we need to do is develop women support group now. We want the younger women them to talk to some other older women and other women, just generally women coming together and discussing their concern so them can relate them abuse or the dangerous situation with them in because women find it very difficult to talk about them abuse. So if you can send them in our environment and then talk to other women, you can encourage them to go report it to the police, to move out of house with this abusive manner and them thing. Then even them same woman, they can assist them in a relocating and other things. So we need women support groups and we want people like Lisa and Bobsy Green to head this initiative. Yeah. When our leaders are a country, we need to step forward and start facilitate them things for the woman them. Because women them vulnerable and them not, many of them want the support what them need, the psychological support to rise up from abuse. Because enough time abuse are going a long time and it will knock out the individuality out of the woman them. The woman them not even know if it turn up for themselves or even if it conceive of the reality that where the man them are do them wrong. So them forget their own rights. And it's time for women come together and talk about their rights because they might get abused. You see me I say? So we want to see the women support group they might develop throughout the parish them. And we want women to start relaying information to other people. This is number 10, the last point. Once the woman them, when they're in a situation of concern, say I go meet somebody on Facebook, on Tinder, or you go on a shady job interview, say I go on an interview where them say, oh, them want a massage therapist, a massage parlor. Many of them time, they are the code word for prostitution and them thing, human trafficking, and you don't realize that. So you go and say, I go get a massage parlor job. Next thing, nobody know you back from you again. And this has happened before in Jamaica. So why you fi report to other people when I go meet people online, when I go shady job interview. When I go anywhere where might questionable, where you doubt your chances of returning. And even carry a friend. Carry somebody too. Sometimes in a certain dangerous situation, take out your phone and go up on Facebook Live. So every video it a video, you know, and go left on your phone if something do you, it goes straight to Facebook. It goes straight to the public. So you just take out your phone, you go up on Facebook Live and you start a video and explain things. You know, say, I'm Sherry Gay Peterson, I came on this job interview, this man tell me I should come upstairs, I come in this dark alley and this place, he walk away and he so come back and I start to suspect that something is wrong because he locked the gate downstairs and I can't come out. You know, then we're there and you explain, you describe him and when he come back, you record him and you make him know, say, yo, me just record up on Facebook Live, you're on Facebook Live, other people are here. So him can't, if him did what plan for try nothing, him knows, right? No more get exposed. At them, I think you only need to think women. Only need to think about protect yourself right now because things are get too dangerous, you know? And own a phone responsibility, on your own. Phone safety, on your own responsibility. You don't have to know that because a man them are killing you. You see me, I say? A man them are go after the woman them. So you don't have to realize it. You don't have to stand up, you don't have to come together and unite and discuss them things there. And start date more responsible men. Stop go with the little violent man, them and the cool kid guy, them and the gallus, them and them thing there. Now for them youth, they don't really got treated to the best level, you know. Need a jealous man them too. Make sure, say, the jealous man them, because really them are commit the murder, suicide, and the kill off the woman, them and them thing there, the jealous man them. So, know who you are date. Watch personality. Talk to other people. And try to keep yourself safe. Because I want the woman them stay safe. All of this what I do is for the woman them stay safe. So, one love Jamaica. Women, keep yourself safe. I love you all of you. Bad, bad, bad. Like, subscribe, comment in the comment section. Share this post so you can help other vulnerable women understand that there are many things that they should be doing to keep themselves safe. Yes, Jamaica. Over and out.